Welcome to Enapps Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, we'll be revisiting the indexing ring I made from the car brake disc. I've had a few comments and people asking questions on how I did things, so I thought it's easier to make a short video and show you. Also, I'd just like to say thank you for the people that sent me comments when I wasn't feeling too well. Thank you very much. I do read all the comments, even though I don't reply to them all. There'd be far too many to reply to. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. So to fit my dividing ring on there, first of all I have to put the chuck on that holds the ring. I'll take this three jaw off. You can see underneath there are two bolts. These hold the dividing ring pin. On most Oxford lathes, these holes are already drilled and tapped by Oxford, and they're there to hold a lever. If you have the collet set, there's a lever that comes up here so you can open the collet and close the collet. So onto these two holes, I made the plunger and the locator, and all it is a piece of plate aluminium. Drill the two holes to match there, two at the top so that can bolt onto there. The two at the top, this cross piece bolts on so I can slide the plunger across to whichever row of holes I need, and then once that's bolted on you turn the end of the plunger and it'll feed it in to go into the hole on the disc. Now if you remember from the first video, this was a car brake disc, so there's a lot of holes in here which I don't need. So the four big holes are where the actual studs held the wheel to the car, and then for some reason there are three smaller holes which you didn't need, they're already in. Just put that hand tight so later I can move it into the correct position. Back this out of the way. So on the back of the chuck plate, I drilled two holes and tapped them, and then if that goes that way, and we put two countersink screws in there. I think these were to hold the disc to the hub. These bolts hold the chuck
back plate to the chuck. And that's on there. There's the other side of the bolts. So I've got four bolts that hold the chuck back plate to the chuck and two countersunk screws that hold the dividing ring to the
chuck back plate, and then the chuck back plate to the
spindle. Just put that on. So once that's fitted and your chuck's fitted, you have the dividing ring now on the back, and all you need to do is line this up . Okay, now tighten the two bolts that hold the indexing arm to the head. So the first thing we do is put the plunger in the hole, line it up. That lines the arm up, and we can tighten the arm. So we've bolted the arm to the headstock, which is fixed. The plunger's in so the chuck won't move. Then all we need to do is decide how many divisions we need to rotate the chuck. And to do that, we just pull this pin out. Once the plunger's in line with the chuck, we can tighten the bracket, stop it moving in and out. And we can tighten the pin up. And that locks the chuck in position. So you can mill the part that you want to mill or drill a hole through.
Using your tool post spindle, which could hold a milling cutter or a drill. Release the locking pin.
Remove the pin. The chuck will turn round, and you can select whichever angle you need. Replace the pin.
I forget how many holes I've drilled in here. 32, I think.
So you just count the holes round, put the pin back in. And then you can drill or mill whatever you have in the chuck. So the first question I had was, how do you fix the arm to the headstock? Well, there should already be some holes drilled and tapped. There will be Imperial 516, I think. And the second question was, how did I fit the ring onto the headstock? Well, I didn't. I fitted the ring to the back of the chuck mounting plate.
And the mounting plate to the spindle.
Make sure it's running true. Well, it's about 5 thou out, so I just skimmed the face. And then someone's going to ask, how do you put the holes in? Well, I did this on the dividing head on the milling machine, centred up on the centre of the ring, and just drill the first hole and then move to the second hole, just go around. Also on this, I can move this plunger back another half inch, so I can put another row of holes in here if I need an angle that I haven't already got. Then when you're finished, just take your chuck off. You see I have enough space at the side for another row of holes. And that's the back plate for the chuck with the bolts holding the chuck on. So all I've drilled are two extra holes
that hold the dividing ring to the back of the chuck. I always leave the bolts in there so I can find them next time I need them. Now, just a tip for you, when you're using the dividing ring and you've got the locking pin in, remember not to turn your lathe on. So to prevent that, what I do is open the door where the belt changes and the interlock switch will switch the power off to the motor. So if I turn the lathe on by accident, the motor won't work, so I'm not going to break the pin in the ring.
And that's the back plate for the chuck with the bolts holding the chuck on. So all I've drilled are two extra holes that hold the
dividing ring to the back of the chuck. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope that was useful. And we'll see you next time on Enoch's Engineering.